So page 66.
66.
Yeah.
And before the class, do they jam master me?
Mm-hmm.
And I heard from Gurudev quite a good story, nice story. Maybe I may share. So Gurudev saying, actually, some people celebrate yesterday jam master me. And then, yesterday's Janmashtami is Mathura Janmashtami. Mm-hmm. Krishna appear Mathura as a midnight. Then Vasudeva, Krishna's father, take Krishna on the hand and try to cross the Jamuna River to go to Gokul. So at that time, Jamuna River, so much ecstasy. And then Yamuna River touched Krishna's lotus feet. And then Krishna is Vasudeva future. So Vasudeva Krishna in the Yamuna, then went to Gokul. Then today, like 10:30, 11 a.m., Yashoda Maya was sleeping and she could not understand which one is coming out, man or girl, boy or girl. Yashoda Maya could not understand. So, and Yashoda Maya find out, oh, this boy. Then today, Vrindavan, well, some Braja, celebrate Janmashtami. And Nanda Maharaj, Nanda Baba, was so pleased because Yashoda Maya is little older. So he was thinking, I may not have son. But Krishna appeared. So, Nanda Maharaj, Nanda Baba want to distribute some toy, many things to others. So this is Gopinatha Bhai explained. This is Nandosabha. So this evening, maybe today in Munger Raj Mandir, 5 p.m., we try to distribute some toys to the children. And there's so much fun. And then, after Krishna, this Braja Leela, Krishna want to go to Mathura. So, Krishna Balaram bathed in Jamuna River. At that time, Vasudeva Krishna again enter the Krishna and then go to Mathura. So this is Gurudeva's talking the story. So sometimes we have two Janmashtami. Because Vrindavan, Braja, Krishna's born in Vrindavan. Krishna appear in Vrindavan. So this is, Brajavasi is believing like this. So sorry, this is a small Gurudeva's talking about Janmashtami. So maybe we may talk a little bit and then hopefully we may enjoy some drama, etc. Or maybe throwing a Nandosava. So six, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Andagaji, could you?
Yes, yes. Thank you. So, yeah. Let us take the example of Hanuman. Garuda came to Hanuman and told him, your worshipable deity is calling you. Your worshipful Shri Krishna wants you to come and take his darshan. Hanuman replied, my health is so bad, I cannot go. I'm seriously ill. Garuda repeated, Krishna is calling you. Hanuman replied, I know, but I'm so tired that I cannot do anything. Then Garuda tried to take Hanuman by force. But Hanuman kicked Garuda with his tail, throwing him with such tremendous force that Garuda at once landed near the palace of Krishna in Dvaraka. Krishna told Garuda, go again. And this time, tell him that Rama is calling him. Garuda returned to Hanuman and told him, your worshipful deity, Rama, is calling you. Hanuman immediately became very joyful and said, I will just take my bath, and as soon as I put on tilak, I'm coming. Please go ahead and tell Rama that I'm coming right away. Garuda said, I will go very quickly, at the speed of mine. Please come with me and ride on my back. Hanuman answered, no, there is no need. I'm coming very soon. You can go on ahead. As Garuda was flying with great speed, reached halfway to Rama, he saw Hanuman coming back, jumping back from having just seen Rama. Hanuman had already seen Krishna in the form of Rama, spoken with him, and paid his respects. And he was now returning, while Garuda was only halfway there. Hanuman had been so eager to see his worshipful Lord, who had now called him, that although he had previously said he was ill due to lack of enthusiasm, he was now able to jump and fly faster than Garuda. faster than the speed of mind.
Yes. So this past tense is describing who is Ishtadeva of Hanuman. So Ishtadeva means most dear, dearest worship of the Lord, we may say. So everybody has a specific Ishtadeva. In the case of Hanuman, Hanuman's Ishtadeva is not Krishna, but Ramachandra. Because Krishna calling Hanuman, but Hanuman does not go to see Krishna enthusiastically. But he said, oh, I'm very sick. I'm very ill. I cannot go. But Garuda said, oh, Rama is calling you. Then he's so enthusiastic. Okay, okay, okay. I'm coming immediately. Please go ahead. So completely Hanuman's mood is different. So we could see Hanuman's Ishtadeva is Ramachandra. And why Narayan Maharaj Gurudev saying this pastime? Because to attain perfection, we must have Ishtadeva, specific Ishtadeva. If we don't have Ishtadeva, then we don't know where we should go. So this pastime is very interesting.
In this way, even if the sadaka with greed is not following some of various limbs of the ninefold practices of bhakti, such as padasevanam, visiting of Lord's pastime places, or archanam, temple worship. If sadaka has that root conception, then his neglect is not an offense. The root bhava will fill up all the gaps in the form of the missing practices. Shruti, Smriti, Puranadi, Pancharatra within Vina, Aikantiki Harer Bhaktir Utpatayaiva Kalpate. Devotional service to Bhagavan that ignores the authorized Vedic literatures such as the Upanishads, Puranas, Narada Pancharatra, etc., is simply an unnecessary disturbance in society. Do you know this shloka? This is a very important shloka from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. And the purport is that if one is engaged in the exclusive worship of Krishna, Aikantiki Harer Bhakti, but he is not following the instructions of Shastras, like Shrutis, Smritis, Pancharatra, Puranas, there will be some disturbance. However, for a person truly established in this root bhakti, a person with genuine greed to serve Radha and Krishna, that alone is sufficient. If that person does not execute whatever limbs of bhakti are unfavorable for advancement in Raganuga, even though Shastra instructs that all the limbs of bhakti should be observed, there is no chance of committing an offense. It is a fact that those who have actual greed and exclusively follow the principles of Raganuga Bhakti will attain service Radha and Krishna in Gopi Bhava.
Yes, this is a very important thing. Generally speaking, so this Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1 to 101, we have to follow Vedic literature, authorized Vedic literature, such Upanishad, Purana, Narada, Pancharatra, etc. If we don't follow, then simply it is unnecessary disturbance in society. This mentioned. But also, Sri Narayana Maharaj said, however, for a person truly established in this root bhakti, a person with genuine greed to serve Radha and Krishna, that alone is sufficient. So if you have greed, means we have ishtadeva, certain ishtadeva, and greed. If more to say, if we fix Stai Baba, then we don't need to follow all rule regulation. No. Even though we may not follow some rule and regulation which is not favorable for Raganuga Bhakti, it is not offense at all. Because Bhakti's goal is fixing Ishtadeva and fixing one Stai Baba. Means we know Sambandha Jnana. further relationship with the Lord, Abhideya. What to do? This is devotional service and prayojana. What is goal? If you fix it, then we don't need to follow all and do, and we don't need to follow everything. But we have to follow which favorable in Raganuga Bhakti. That is Narayan Maharaj's his essence, is saying, especially Narayan Maharaj consigns, he said, Gopi Baba. But actually, he's stressing Manjari Baba. So if we fix it, then we don't need to follow all rule and regulation. We have to follow which favorable to our Raga Nuga, Raga Bhakti. This is the point.
Mm. There is an important thing to note in this connection. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur tells us, it is sometimes said that if a sadaka has an ambition to serve Sri Sri Radha Krishna with Raga, and he is engaged only in the hearing, chanting, and the remembering of Vaidhi Bhakti, he will attain Dvaraka Bhava. And become a maid servant of Rukmini and Satyabhama. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur writes that it is also sometimes said that if a sadaka has greed and performs Vaidhi Bhakti plus Raganuga Bhakti, he will become a maid servant of the queens of Mathura. He writes that these conceptions are not correct. The queen of Mathura is Kubja. And the queens of Dvaraka are Rukmini, Satyabhama, and others like them. It is not correct to say that a person performing Vaidhi Bhakti receives service to the queens of Dvaraka, or that a person with greed who performs both Vaidhi and Raganuga Bhakti receives service to Kubja. Kubja's prema is not actually proper, and therefore it is naturally less than that of the queens of Dvaraka. Janandaji, maybe we should read this note about Kubja.
Okay, please.
Yeah. This is very nice, the explanation. Kubja was a hunchbacked maid servant of Kamsa who developed conjugal attraction for Krishna upon seeing him. But Kubja desired Krishna for her own happiness. And therefore, her love has been condemned. Her love cannot be compared to that of the queens of Dwaraka or Vraja Gopis. So we continue. The queens of Dwaraka are so much superiors to Kubja. Vaidhi performed along with Raganuga is superior to the performance of Vaidhi alone. Do you understand? It is against the principles of bhakti that a person performing Vaidhi bhakti plus Raga Nuga bhakti would receive the inferior position of service of Kubja, while the performance of Vaidhi bhakti alone would yield a superior position.
This is very interesting point. I may not understand everything, but I try to explain. If we practice so Vaidhi bhakti and Raganuga bhakti, so and then Vaidhi bhakti plus Raganuga bhakti. So what's happening? Generally speaking, if we practice Vaidhi bhakti, then we go to Vaikuntha. But to enter Braja, Vrindavan, we have to follow completely in the footstep of gopis, Sakhi and Manjari. Without Aishwarya Baba, then we can enter Braja. Then if we, and then Naramaj mentioned this Kubja, I don't know. It is Kubja is queen of Krishna. I never heard. If somebody knows, please teach me. And it say here in say footnote, Kubja is not pure love. Actually, prema is to please Krishna. But the Kubja is mixing. Oh, I want to enjoy the tendency there. So therefore, Dwaraka's queen is much better. Maybe better than Kubja. This Nara Maharaj is stressing. So, if we have raga, but practicing Vaidhi means no feeling, follow rule and regulation, then we may go maximum Dwaraka. Yesterday, or maybe day before yesterday, Gurudev was saying a very interesting comment. Goloka and Goloka Vrindavan is different. Goloka and Goloka Vrindavan is different. Goloka Vrindavan is like Vrindavan. But Goloka is Radha and Krishna is there. But they are married. They are worshipping certain rules and regulations. This is Goloka. This is very interesting. But Shastra mentioned Braja is Madhurya, only Madhurya. Aishwarya Baba is there, but Madhura is so condensed, covers all Madhura, Aishwarya Baba. Therefore, in Braja, nobody think Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. No. In Brajavasi, they are thinking Krishna is my son, like Nanda Lal. Or Krishna is my friend. Or Krishna is my lover. This is Braja's mood. Gopi never think Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. If Gopi thinks Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, Gopi cannot joke with Krishna. Or Gopi cannot criticize Krishna. This is offense. But Gopi's love is so strong, covered completely Aishwarya Baba. And then Krishna feel more blissfulness just by criticizing Krishna. Krishna is kind of tired, always glorifying Krishna. Krishna is tired. But sometimes very fresh, some Brajavasi criticize Krishna, and then Krishna is very happy. So this is an interesting point. If somebody could add or some comments, very welcome. Gora Chandra Prabhu, you could add.
Radhe Radhe, nice to see you in Vrindavan Maharaj.
Yes.
This is our goal of life.
Yes. Yeah.
What we are talking now is very difficult subject, like, no? And you need to study that. You need some knowledge and some brain. I don't have so much of that. So I want to go back a little to the beginning of the lecture, where Jayananda Maharaj mentioned that we have here example of Sai Bhav, Hanumanji, Ishtadev. He is only in love with Ram. So I think that is just the most important point for us to know. We have to fix our Ishtadev and we have to connect with the feeling. For me, that is enough. I don't want to know, or I don't need to know what is the mix of Vaidhi and this, because I'm not very intelligent to understand that. So last time I spoke about this one Leela when Krishna and Gopis, Radharani, they fear, play hide and seek. And Krishna, he assumed the form of Narayan. And then the gopis came And there you also can see, there's Daibhav. Even in front of the God, they are fixed. They just asked, did you see Krishna? They have a Ishtadeva. And I forgot to mention one very beautiful thing to that Leela also. That actually first the gopis came and they see the Narayan and they ask him, where's Krishna? But then Radharani came. And Krishna, he could not maintain his form as a Narayana. His form starts shivering. His body starts bending. His flute falls from the dhoti. So that is the power of Radharani's love. There is no place for Narayan in front of Radharani. So then I want to share something. In the beginning of the lecture, we read that maybe we have to follow some certain rules in society. If we not do, then we cause disturbance. Different devotees from all over the world, they grown up in different cultures. Maybe from Europe, many devotees, they were raised in Christian tradition. So I think not to create a conflict, to reject everything. No, I'm not Christian. I am Krishna devotee. Why to give pain to father and mother? Why not go together with them in the church and pray to Jesus that he may help you to achieve your goal, to become Radha Dasi? In Narottam Das Thakur's song, Sri Rupa Manjari Padal, he mentioned, this is the lotus feet of Rupa Manjari, they are my brata, my tapa, my dharma karma. Everything I do, I have a goal. And with this goal in mind, I can bow down to everyone, even to the dogs in the street, to ask them for the mercy that I can become Radha Dasi. We can pray to Hanuman. Why not? Hanuman, you are so one-pointed. I need that to fix myself in lotus feet of Radharani. Why not bow down to Shivji? He is greatest Vaishnava. And certainly, there are many powerful devatas in this universe. Why not bow down to them and ask them, please help me to become Radha Dasi? So there's no conflict. I think we also in Japan, there are certain rules. People, festivals, they go to the temple. Maybe devotees, they don't like this so anymore. But just go there and pray. Just pray. Every temple, every place of prayer is welcome to achieve our goal. We need help from everyone. So, yeah. Yeah. Rade, rade.
So actually, this is a very good point. So Narayan Maharaj is talking about ISKCON leaders. So they are very philosophically minded. So Narayan Maharaj was saying, but actually very simple. Fixing Ishtadeva, fixing one Baba and stay Baba. That's it. And we don't need to worry so much. That's correct. Okay. Then.
Huh? Actually, I have a question. Narayan Maharaj say that if you don't worship, then there's no offense and like this, no? Speaking little about offense and aparad, what will happen if I do offense? What will happen to me? Mm-hmm. I have to go to hell or what? What? I mean, I'm full of mistakes. Probably I commit so many aparada. What will happen to me, Maharaj?
So this is up to Radha Mohan. And also that devotee also. Like, you know, I cannot say, but you know the story, the Leela. Rupa Goswami, I think like Radha Kunda or somewhere, you know, some place, he's doing Leela Smarana. And then at that time, unknowingly, some crooked person, like a lame, he can walk, but a little bit funny walking. Rupa Goswami was Krishna's doing very funny Leela and then little smiling. But that devotee who walk little bit, you know, like a funny way. That devotee thinking, oh, Rupa Goswami is laughing at me. So that devotee felt like this. Rupa Goswami did not do any offense. But that devotee took, oh, Rupa Goswami laughing at me, my seeing my body. They immediately, Leela Smaran stopped. And Rupa Goswami completely shocked and almost crying. He does not know why Leela Smaran stopped. Again, he tried again. Never happened. So he approached certain devotee. Then that devotee said, oh, maybe you may commit offense, maybe unknowingly. So better to you go every Vaishnava and forgive offenses. And then Rupa Goswami visit every devotee, because at that time Braja is not so many, like not now, you know. It knows. And then Rupa Goswami pay obeisance, you know, if I commit offense, please forgive me. And then he approached that person who like walking very funny way. And then he said, you know, he did not say, you know, he did not forgive. And then Rupa Goswami said, explain his story. Or oh, actually, you know, I don't want to commit any offense to anybody. But one day, I did Leela Smaranam in, you know, I don't know, Radha Kunda or someone else. At that time, Krishna Leela is so funny. I'm a little bit smiling. And then after that, my Leela Smaranam stopped. And that devotee could understand, oh, Rupa Goswami is not laughing at me. He's laughing the seeing Krishna Leela. So he realized, I misunderstand Rupa Goswami. I misunderstand you. I was thinking you seeing my body, my walking funny, then you may laughing at me. But actual reality is not like this. You are laughing to seeing Radha Mohan's Leela. Oh, sorry, I misunderstood your activity. Please, you know, I forgive you. You also forgive me like this. And then Rupa Goswami Leela Smaran again start like this. So if we commit offense, if we think we commit offense, then we have to apologize. This is best way. But sometimes we don't know we may commit offense or not. We don't know. Then solution is, I think, two. Just doing always Kirtaniya Sadahari. Because holy name might be kind to us. So if unknowing commit offense, then we try to chant as much as possible. That's one way of solution. Another way is serving Vaishnava. Always try to serve Vaishnava. Any Vaishnava, junior, senior, everybody, or even ordinary person also. If serving, then our ego slowly disappear. So therefore, serving the Vaishnava is another best policy. And our misunderstanding is coming from duality. This is high person, this is low person, this is good, this is bad. This is correct, this is wrong. Sometimes we see material eyes. Oh, I'm senior than him. I know than him, and like this. So we have to beyond this duality, means false ego. To beyond false ego, to serving Sadhu Guru Vaishnava is best way. Also, always be humble to anybody, even aunt. We feel he also servant of Radha. If we see everybody Radha Dasi, then we may not commit any offense. But sometimes, unknowingly, we may commit offense. Therefore, but still we have to keep doing. This is Radha Mohan's, Radha Mohan's hand. So sometimes we may suffer, or sometimes we may feel some difficulty, but it doesn't matter. Our business is just to, you know, stay above and keep doing, keep bhajan, keep serving the devotee. That is, I think, our way to do. So Gaura-chan is very kind to us. He knows, but on behalf of us, he's asking. He's very kind. Thank you, Gaura-chandra. If you could add, you know, please add, you know.
If we do unknowingly, I think it's just a mistake, right? Because we don't know. Why Mahaprabhu, why Radharani, why Gurudev should be angry? We are babies. We don't know anything. So why they should be angry with me? I am big Abarari. I can share a big story. of my big apparat.
Okay, please.
I was traveling with Gurudev.
Yeah.
In Europe. Personal servant.
Wow.
3 weeks.
Wow.
I became tired. One day, Gurudev became a little angry. What about the luggage, blah, blah. I say, no, this devotee wanted to take care. Gurudev, don't argue with me. It's your responsibility. My ego coming? Too much. Tired. Ego. Secretly, I left. Bye-bye. Leaving alone Gurudev in this circumstance. I knew Suniti is with him, Kalindi, they will take care. Okay. I took bus from Zurich, Switzerland, to Berlin, go to my village, call Gurudev. Sorry, Gurudev. Say, no problem. No problem. Of course, I feel a little guilty, and then it was summertime. September, October, maybe I go back to Vrindavan. Little bad feeling. I go down to Gurudev in the room, and he just smiling with his big loving eyes. Gaurachandra, start crying almost. I'm so happy you came back to me. Wow. My heart melting. No? Gurudev, what I can say. So. Vaishnava means he will find the right spot on my black paper.
Could you say again? Vaishnava means?
He will find white spot on black paper. I'm like black paper. But my Gurudev, he will find white spot. And he will make this white spot, he will grow that. He will not say, this is not good. He never say, you do mistake and this and that and blah, blah, blah. No, he only improve my white spot, my white spot. That is the mercy of my Guruji. So, I never can repay the love he gave me. Long time in my life, nobody could control me. My mother cannot control me. Government cannot control me. Institutions cannot control me. Only Gurudev can control me with his love. That control, it's okay. By love, he controls me. So, if you do mistakes, no problem. Mahaprabhu, most merciful incarnation. But if we knowingly do, like I know it's not good at doing, then that is not good, I think. But unknowingly, just continue. We are full of mistakes.
Beautiful. So also Vaishnava's one quality, good quality, Brahman Vaishnava quality is forgiveness. So this tendency, any Vaishnava I've seen, good quality is forgiveness and very kindness, mercifulness. Mahaprabhu is very kind, magnanimous, but Mahaprabhu could not tolerate someone who offended devotees. That is Mahaprabhu cannot tolerate. Because Jagai Madai, Madai commit offense to Nitai. Then Mahaprabhu could not tolerate. He want to kill him. But Nitai say, no, Mahaprabhu. In this incarnation, you are showing us not killing by love. You are distributing by love, not killing by chakra. And one quality, someone who is premi bhakta, he can control Krishna and his devotees because of love. So our Gurudev is like this. Gaurachandra was controlled. Even government cannot control Gaurachandra. Our parents cannot control Gaurachandra. But by love, he is controlled. So this is, we are controlled by love. We are not rule and regulation may control to some extent, or sometimes we may control, but after sometimes, no. Parents may control to some extent or a while, but also, parents cannot control completely, but by love, sometimes we cannot escape. We are controlled. This is Raga Bhakti. This is Gaurachandra. Show us. Thank you. Thank you, Gaurachandra.
Radharani, same, na? She's not in control. Nobody can stop her love.
Not true.
Kapila, Kutila, they can talk. Fixed. Yes. Control by love. Yes. Oh, Radharani.